You were voted out seconds into the game. You're now on a tribe of people who've played before you've never played. Do you belong out here?
Well, Jeff, I feel very much a part of this tribe and a part of the decision making and a part of the play.
I'm an adopted child. All I have for blood in this world is my mother. I have my adopted family. I've got my wife, her family, friends that I consider my family, but my scenario really isn't much different than hers.
So you had domestic violence in your upbringing?
I'm an adopted child.
Dan, not to split hairs, but that's a very big difference.
Again, not taking anything away from what happened.
You have one extra member. Who are you going to sit out?
Abby, I got to ask, of all the challenges we've had, how many of you participated in?
Two.
Both tribes working together well. Everybody in on this challenge, except for Abby, sitting out yet again. Dan Dang, congratulations.
Yeah, ladies.
Probably Malcolm who should be holding that.
No, give it to
Malcolm.
I mean, I live in a town of 3,000 people, and yes, I did go to a private, like, all-white school, but I do have, like, African-American people in my life.
Who?
My housekeeper.
So, I mean, like, that just put us on a weird vibe from day one.
But she's like a member of our family. Like, she's...
A paid member.
Yes. I mean, you know, yeah, she didn't work for free.
What do you think we should do with your torch?
What happened to theirs? It got smuffed.
Smuffed.
Is that the word, smuffed?
But, Nyanka, they didn't quit. Purple Kelly, what do you think should be done with your torch? You guys are quitters.
I think it should be snuffed, too.
All right, so I'll snuff your torches, but we're going to keep them here at Tribal Council. They'll be a reminder to you guys when you come back in here as part of the jury of the decision you made to quit.
Everybody
Coach
now.
Leading the tribe of villains, using all of that life experience in a kayak. Jason going to Exile Island.
But this is also good for Jason if he gets the immunity idol. Like, I don't know why he's tripping.
That's true. This time, maybe you'll get a real one. Danielle, Terry said, I'm going to keep winning him. You mumbled, here we go again.
Because he always talks about how he's so competitive and he's so great at everything. And it's all about Terry. But power to him for being as confident and cocky as he is, but...
I think it's an interesting comment coming from you, seeing how confident you were today and how cocky the six of you have been for the last several tribals.
Yeah, but I don't think we're coming off as strongly as Terry does. He's a super competitive guy. I'm not knocking that. I'm very competitive as well. And
is that part of the problem, that you can't beat him and it frustrates you?
I mean, it is frustrating.
Russell, is one of the reasons you like how Danielle plays is that the more she plays, the less chance she has of winning?
I tell you what, she's fighting to get further in the game. If she gets further in the game, I get further in the game.
I've said from the very beginning that I wanted to walk the path of the noble warrior and finding that great competition that you could pit yourself against.
And then you voted out Brendan.
Yeah. I will explain this to you.
I'm sure you will.
Because Brendan pitted himself against me. If it's war, one-on-one.
I thought that's what you wanted.
Exactly, and I won. Thank you. Exactly. I outsmarted him, I outfoxed him, and at the moment, sorry to say, I'm outleading him.
At the challenge, the winners get enough luxury to keep them strong until the end.
Oh, man.
And as for the losers, they will be taken and executed.
I don't treat people that way, and...
I don't treat people that way.
Okay, can I talk?
Yes, I don't want you to paint me as something I'm not.
Just, why don't you go ahead?
That is... an ironic statement.
I know.
We see that season after season where people take kind of the dead weight, they take the unlikable person, they take that they
believe.
Wow,
that I never thought I was the unlikable person.
I'm just saying, in seasons past, I'm not just putting you in that box, Abby. But we've seen that, you know, we have.
I want to interrupt.
Yeah.
Abby, you didn't grasp that you're seen as unlikable?
I didn't, no. I seriously did not grasp that I was that hated in the game.
Abby, I'm beginning to believe very much that it's cultural, because you didn't grasp that people laughing at you was a sign in our culture that you're full of it.
Yeah.
Well, for the first time, I have a vote. I have no idea who it belongs to. Who wrote Bye Bye Denver Diva? Who's the name?
Gandia.
Gandia.
Bimber. Diva.
In the future, write a name down, okay? Enough with the nicknames.
I fell in love in this game. Love at first sight. Her name is Candace. And in between...
Candace from Roro Tribe.
Yeah. After the last challenge, we sort of mouthed the words I love you to one another. And so that was my prize. And my prize was her.
I've never heard anything that surprised me more than what you just said.
Pizza, brownies, and volcano surfing. Benry makes the best move of the challenge for the yellow team with the ceremonial loser dismount.
I feel like everyone's been avoiding me. I feel like a leper on this tribe, I do.
But is that just because you're used to getting attention all the time in life?
No, Jeff, but you're right. But no, I think.
We all gelled really quickly in a way that White Collar never did. And you're making a face.
I am?
Yes. Like I'm delusional. No, okay, sorry.
Wait. No, I'm hold on. Okay. Let me check myself, because maybe the Botox isn't working. It seems weird that I would make a reaction to you saying it feels like a new home. That seems like an ordinary comment to make.
Okay, you just look really intense.
Okay, well, that's just me.
Okay.
Heidi, what the heck is going on with your knee?
I wish I knew. I mean, it's getting better, though. It's getting better, and I think, honestly, probably in 2 days, I'll be good to go.
Did it concern you at all? I mean, this is an individual game.
Oh my gosh, yes. I'm sitting here, okay, my strongest assets to this group are athletic ability and intelligence. And hello, one of those are gone right now.
Which one?
Well, that's a very good question.
We're gonna lose all our
Rero just wasted a cannonball. They weren't paying attention. Dropped it right through the chute. What's that?
No, please.
Jonathan getting frustrated by me.
Eric drops the fourth tile from
Molly
Call.
Hurry.
Bull, we say bull, bull, bull.
Kenner, you got the same tiles, the same ropes.
Damn. I mean, my ass.
What?
All right, you need to stop bitching and start throwing.
Just hitting him as hard as we can, Jeff.
10 seconds left.
Before what happens?
Before you got to get off the boat, brother. You've played this game before.
You know, lots of people like to watch adventure. It doesn't necessarily mean they really should get up off the couch. And I'm now convinced that Colton is the guy who never should have got up off the couch. We brought a quitter back, and we got to quit again.
I don't care what y'all say.
33 days in, it is as if this is a foreign language being learned for the first time. Both teams absolutely stumped. Start thinking, Survivor. Been on for 30 seasons. I say the same 200 words over and over and over and over and over. I'm in therapy, I say the words so often.
Jeff, right. Jeff, we have a kind of a not traditional situation that we'd like to propose to you.
Okay.
Our tribe seems to have misplaced our flint. And so we were wondering if we could potentially barter with you and take the fishing equipment, but trade you the beans for our flint. First, let me understand the situation. So the tribe with two firemen, Heath and Jeremy, you've lost them.
It's gone, Jeff.
So you want to make a trade, but you want to keep the fishing gear and you want to trade the beans. Walk me through this from a negotiation standpoint. You're the ones who need to make the deal. My life is fine. So you come in, survey the scene, see what the reward is, and then offer me the thing of least value. Probably a half a bag of beans at this point, I'm guessing.
A little bit more than that.
Jeff, if you don't ask, you don't know, so.
It's almost full.
It's
a better negotiation would have been to walk in at the top of the challenge, say, can we trade our beans straight up? Because what you did is you came in to see if you would win, and then leverage that. And that doesn't work on Survivor.
Well, a kiss is nice. Maybe if it were love, he'd have given you the immunity necklace. Candace.
Tribe has spoken.
Can I interject?
Yeah.
there's also a lot of added reasons why we should go to the end together. Not least is this breakfast that we've talked about having on day 39 since day two. You know, we've
just you know, I gotta admit, when you weigh $1 million versus a breakfast with your 39-day friend, you're right. That's a tough one.
I mean, look, my point is that there's more to a relationship than $1 million.
Let me ask you this, Stephen. He doesn't pick you. He takes Aaron and he wins. You're not friends after this?
I mean, I think we would be friends. I don't think it would be the same kind of friendship.
What are you basing your vote on?
Trying to figure out how the heck we can bond together in these challenges and win. But I made alliances that and promises that I want to keep.
So it sounds like what you're saying with that long pause is not sure it will be the best vote, but I will be keeping my word.
That is exactly what I am saying. I am keeping my word. I am going to stand up to what I said.
What part of that makes sense? Keeping your word in a game called Outwit, Outplay, Outlast? Keeping your word because I'm an honorable man and I want people to see me that way? Because I'm looking at a tribe who, y'all keeping your word, great. All it's doing is giving you more time with me at Tribal Council.
And sitting here at Tribal Council sucks. And I know
you're a part of the reason based on that philosophy, Rupert. That's the most honest and illuminating answer we've had in any of our tribals together.
Here's what's at stake for the winner. New Chevy Trailblazer. Not a bad truck. And if Brian knew how to spell road trip, he'd already own one.
There's no regrets how I played the game. I don't regret anything that I did.
Because, I mean, leave it to me to say, one of those dumbass girls beat your ass for $1 million.
We've decided it's four girls that we're gonna spend to go.
Laura B. revealed the women's plan, hoping to spare Vetus's feelings.
I felt like I could trust Laura B., but now I just don't know.
And in the end, she got her wish.
Laura.
Saving Vetus's feelings by getting herself voted out.
Laura, the tribe has spoken.
Jeff, this is it!
Think she has it.
Isn't it?
Not right! Michaela's not right and kicks the puzzle, which always helps.
If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Hey, Jeff. Hold up, bro. I just always wanted to say that.
Okay. Once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted out will be asked to leave the Tribal Council area immediately.
Mind over matter, let's go. Kobe getting centered. There you go. And it doesn't help, Kobe's out. Bobby John is across.
Yes!
And he beats himself up as a reward.
Alicia. Throws it like a little kid. Last time, Alicia had no luck.
Throw it as hard as you can.
Once again, way short.
What the?
My nephew could throw it further than that. Think about what you're doing and throw this thing.
Come on, Alicia, hard, hard.
Oh. Alicia, pathetic.
You look at our group, and yeah, we might have two of the three biggest guys in the whole thing, but we also have two of the weakest girls, and that's just a matter of fact.
Who are the two weak? Obviously, you're going to be pointing to Courtney because she's the smallest.
Well, Courtney and Leslie is who I'm referring to.
This is fun to live with.
You know, it's not that I perceive Leslie as weak or Courtney as weak, to be honest with you.
Jean Robert, that is exactly what you said.
Okay, the weaker of this group.
So, fair play, are you dressing like me?
You want to know what you're playing for?
I'm actually impressed. I like to know that you have aspirations to get out of your current place in life.
Wow. Good to see you, Jeff. Always a pleasure.
Ben, say that when this game started, you had a 100% chance of winning. Where do you think it's at now?
I got as good a chance as anybody.
You believe, based on how you've acted, that your chances of winning are as good as anybody else left in the game?
I definitely do. You know what? I'm straightforward with people. And I'm one of those people, I do not start a fight.